The Clone Source palette offers extended options for the clone tool and allows you to set multiple clone sources. I'm sure it's a precious feature for photographers. As a fashion designer, I don't use clone tool or clone palette for that matter. I find it easy just to select, copy, and paste. Next two palettes, character and paragraph, are related to text. Character palette provides you with all the options from the option bar, like font and size, and in addition allows you to adjust the spacing and widths and heights of your letters. And in the paragraph palette, you can find additional text formatting options. Personally, I was just fine with all the options available in the option bar, so I'm just going to close this entire window. And the final palette in the default workspace is the layer composition. It is a very cool and handy feature, somewhat similar to the history snapshot. Layer composition remembers your layer positioning, visibility, and style, and I use it a lot for my presentation boards. Instead of saving different versions of the same presentation as separate files, I can have one document with as many layouts and styling as I want, accessible with a simple click. Let's see how it works. We are going to start with saving the layout we have. To do so, just click on Create New Layer Composition shortcut at the bottom of the palette. I'm going to have everything checked and keep the default name. Next, we are going to move layers and groups around and create another composition. Click on the icon at the bottom of the palette to save your new layout and click OK. Last document state at the top of the layers composition remembers the last state even if it wasn't saved. And to apply saved settings, simply click on the far left section of the desired composition. You can also scroll through the states using the left and right arrow key at the bottom of the palette. And of course, you can delete, duplicate, and modify layer composition at any time. To duplicate layer composition, simply click and drag it to the Create New Layer Composition icon at the bottom of the palette, or use Palette Menu. To delete, simply click on the Delete icon. To modify already existing layer composition, first make sure it's selected, then make the desired changes, and when you're done, click on the Update Layer Composition icon at the bottom of the palette. As you can see, Layers Composition not only remembers layers' position within the document, but also layer styling and visibility. As opposed to the history snapshots that get discarded as soon as document is closed, Layer Composition will be saved with your document and will be available to you every time you open it. As I was introducing you to the workspace, I made some changes to suit my needs. And just like with almost everything in Photoshop, I can save my workspace for future use. To do so, you can use Workspace shortcut in the option bar. Simply click on the icon for the pull-down menu and choose Save Workspace. Once saved, Adobe Photoshop will list it in the Workspace menu. And at any time, you can go back to the default workspace and go back to your saved one. Just to remind you, all the available palettes are listed in the window pull-down menu in the alphabetical order. So if you accidentally closed one, just go to Window and choose the desired palette.
Learn how to create textiles, including plates and print repeats, generate colorways, and create presentation boards with our Adobe Photoshop for the Fashion Industry ebook. Visit us online at designersnexus.com for tons of free croquis, flat sketches, backgrounds, swatches, and textures. Also, check out our store for Illustrator and Excel tutorials, fashion stitch and trim brushes, sweater brushes, pre-drawn flat sketch templates, and other sketch details. designersnexus.com